Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So before I start with this episode, I'm just gonna be talking about a couple of things. First, if you click the link somewhere here at the top, I have linked my Lomo Diary article as featured by Lomography a couple of days back, so I would be more than happy to if you guys read that and like that as well. The second one would be another link that I'll be posting somewhere on this website. It's a tupf.ca. If you happen to be in Toronto between March 9th, which is tomorrow, till like probably the 23rd, I'm not too sure. Toronto is hosting its first urban photography festival, so you can download the event guide because there's lots of activities going on during that 2 weeks, and I actually recommend you to visit the March 15 installation of the Building Giants. If you guys say hi to the winner of the Building Giants local and then tell him that you found about the exhibit from this channel, I think he will tell you lots of stories depending on how talkative he is on that day. And the third one would be I will be posting a video in the next few weeks that will answer a couple of your photography questions, especially like beginner ones, to those people who are actually worried about starting into film or don't know where to start, or if you guys have watched my older videos and you have some questions that I haven't answered yet, feel free to comment below in this video, and I will be taking all those questions, as well as I'll try to backdate and see what other questions that I haven't answered. I'll try to answer them in one video. So that's something that's really fun, because I wanted to have like a more relaxed type of episode where I'm kind of like just talking about random stuff about photography, which I usually do with my friends. So anyway, onto this episode, I will be quickly talking about the Bel-Air X612 by Lomography. Now, you probably have seen my unboxing video, and I will also link down my first impression article that I actually wrote for Lomography a couple of months back. Now, I actually waited until I got a couple of rolls run through this camera, because it's one of the cameras that I actually like from Lomography, aside from the LC wide and the fisheye. I actually like the fisheye camera, but obviously I have a couple of quirks about it. Just to go over it really quickly, the bellows doesn't really snap close properly, so it's actually a big disadvantage for me, because when I go out, like say if I go to work or if I need to meet up with friends, I usually bring more than one camera, and I'm actually really worried if this doesn't snap close, because there was a time where it actually popped up open in my purse, so something that I don't like. I have a Twitter friend said that he actually had to put a rubber band around it so that it won't pop up open, but I mean, that's really inconvenient considering that you had to use that kind of method for like a $200-something camera. I would actually be happy if this part right here is actually made of metal so that it will actually snap properly, but I mean, it's just me. I don't know. Another thing is that so far from my photos, I actually got the best results using the 90mm lens, which is this one. But that is also because I got the benefit of like reading other people's results based from like taking the photos using both the 58 and the 90. So far the best experience was like this, the 90 millimeter and a 400 ISO colored negative. I'm guessing it will probably be the same thing with if I use a 400 ISO black and white, but I think I haven't done that yet. Well, I think I did, but something happened. I had a big accident with developing, so yikes. Otherwise, it's an okay camera. Would I recommend you to buy like something more like more expensive than this? Probably not. If you really want to try it, I would just recommend to buy like the plastic, the all black body one. I mean, the reason that I bought this is actually like the skin, and I'm not sure if I'm actually happy with that decision because I brought this with a couple of cameras as well, and I think one of my cameras scratched my Bel-Air, so there's a couple of scratches there now. But I guess I'll just wear it like a badge of honor because that means I'm using the camera, right? What else did I forget? Just make sure that you read the instructions properly and how to load the battery. I never had problems with it because I actually read the manual before I used it. Also, I don't think I'll be shooting this camera using the 6x6 format because another reason why I bought this is because I wanted to shoot a medium format panorama, and I got that with 6x9 and also 6x12. If you don't like scanning, I think you would like scanning 6x12 because technically you're just scanning 6 photos and it's been so easy, and I really really like it because usually I find 35mm scanning to be a bit tedious, but I like scanning medium format, so but yeah, like I don't think I'll be shooting 6x6 with this one. I'd rather shoot like using my TLR if I want square photos, or if I want that soft vignetting look, I would probably just use the Diana F+. And I have the original, I have like, not original Diana, but one of the older Diana units. I have one with me as well. And one last thing, and this is very minor. I don't like the sound of that, but, well, what can you do? But in general, I actually find it a lot easy to use. Am I gonna get the glass lens as mentioned in my first impression article? Right now I'm not too sure. I had the opportunity of getting it in like a low price because I had a bunch of piggy points, but I actually ended up buying lots of film instead because I've read a lot of comments about like they're just waiting for other people to buy it, and I haven't seen a lot of results yet. And actually on Flickr I've seen a bunch of Bel-Air photos that were just taken using the plastic lens, and they're really fantastic. Well, aside from the lens, it's obviously because the conditions were good and whoever the photographers are, like they really know what they're doing. So I think that's one of the main thing as well. In my case, I am still in the process of using the Bel-Air, but one thing that I will probably not use this anymore is to take people photos, because like what I mentioned before, I'm so bad at zone focusing, although this one's not too bad, it's actually easier for me to use it, but because of the zone focusing, like I am unable to like gauge like when I get people's head cut off on the photos. But I actually love the photos taken, like cityscape and landscape, and all that, like places in general. This one is a good camera for that one. especially in the city, if like say if you have like wide roads and people are like walking and busy trying to go somewhere else, like it's one good camera. So that's something where I want to use it. Hopefully they come up with a hard case for this one, because right now, because of how the camera doesn't close properly, it's hard for me to like keep it tightly safe and tight in my camera bag. So it's something that I'm kind of worried about. So hopefully lomography comes up with a camera bag, or somewhere in Asia someone will come up with like a generic camera bag for the Bel-Air. Like I would certainly buy that off on eBay. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this quick video. Not really quick, I guess, because I've covered a lot. This video will feature a couple of the photos I've taken with Bel-Air. I'm actually looking forward to taking more photos. Just to give you the specifics, I've shot 200 ISO slide film cross process. I've shot 100 ISO black and white, and I've also shot 400 ISO black and white indoors, and I've shot 400 ISO colored negative, both on an overcast day and on a bright winter sunny day. So, just to give you an idea, because that I think also varies, because I'm using it under f/16. So, I would recommend if you guys use like a faster speed lens. Oh, faster speed film. Anyway, it's Friday. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and have a great weekend. Bye, guys.